Making money on social media is one of the easiest ways to get started with making money online, but it does require you to post daily videos. And I know what you're thinking, that would take way too long. What if I tell you that it doesn't? What if I tell you that you could earn hundreds of dollars per month by using AI while only taking 1 hour in one single day in order to generate you a month's worth of videos to post on social media that will gain you monetizable traffic? Sounds interesting, right? Which is why in this video, I'll show you exactly how you can do this entire process using AI, from coming up with the video ideas to bulk creating the videos and how exactly you can monetize the traffic you're getting. So the first thing you need to do is get topic ideas that you'll be using in your video. And in order to do this, you'll come over to ChatGPT and then you're going to ask it this prompt. Give me 30 video ideas for social media posts for a social media page about top 5 blank that can be created using stock footage. And then you're telling it to fill in the blank. Now the reason why I'm creating a page like this is because these pages tend to get thousands to tens of thousands of views. Now you don't have to create a page like this. You can create a page any way you prefer. Just be sure to perform your own research to find a page that you would want to create. And then I'm going to hit enter for this prompt. And just like that, you now have your entire month's worth of content to post without even having to think about it. Now that you have your different topic ideas, it's time for you to start generating your videos. And in order to do this, we're going to be using InVideo. You could find a link for InVideo in the description of this video. But once on InVideo, you're going to come to this page and you can sign up for your account, or you could go ahead and log into your account if you already have one. And then once you're logged in, as you can see, it's going to be taking you to your dashboard where you can see the designs you've created, or if it's new, you wouldn't see any designs. But once on this page, what you want to go ahead to click is AI text to video. Then once you've clicked this, you're going to go to the side here where it says portrait and click that as well. And then once you've done that, if you scroll through, you can see that there are many different templates that you could go ahead and use. But when you find one, all you need to do is put your mouse over it to see what it looks like, or you can go ahead to give it a click. And then once you click it, it's going to be playing so you can decide if this is the right template for you. And if it is, you're going to go ahead to this side over here and click use templates. So then it's going to bring you to this page. Now once on this page, if you notice in the corner over here, it says ask AI to write your script. This is what you want to be using. So in order to use this, you're going to go ahead and give it a click. Then once you click on it, it says describe the script you want to generate. You don't have to think of this from your head because you've already generated this. So then you're going to head back over to ChatGPT, and then once on ChatGPT, you're going to go ahead and copy the first video idea. Then you're going to come back to InVideo, and then you're going to paste it into this little box, and then you're going to click generate. And within a mere couple of seconds, our script is already generated. What you do want to do is read through this, make sure it makes sense, make sure you like everything it's saying, make sure it delivered on what you requested. And then once you've read through it, what you want to do is come to the bottom here where you're telling it to auto suggest images and videos. And what you want to do is also click iStock and premium. Now the reason is you don't only want to utilize free images, you want to ensure that you're giving the AI the opportunity to use all the clips available to it, which in this case is over 8 million. So once you've done that, click where it says create scenes, and now you just sit back and relax and wait for AI to create your video for you. And then once InVideo has finished generating you your video, and note well, it takes only about 30 seconds to do this. Once on this page, this is the storyboard where you're able to see the different lines of your script. And then within the storyboard, you could also click onto the different lines of your script. You can double click and go ahead and edit it if you want, but everything would already been intact. So what you will need to do is come over to where it says editor. And then once on editor, you'll now be able to see all your different clips, and you could see how long your video is, etc. When you get to this part, what you need to do is go through the different images and change the ones that don't quite fit. For example, this one. In order to make these changes, you could use royalty-free videos or images. Now, note well that InVideo has over 8 million clips that you could choose to use from sources like Pexels, Pixabay, and even more premium sources like Shutterstock and iStock. So in order to find something that I may want, I'm looking for something that's along the line of destination, so I can go ahead and type in the word destination. And now that I've done that, as you can see, it's giving me many different types of videos, so I can go through the different ones they have and find one that interested me. And then once you found a clip that you like, in order to replace the old one with the new one, all you need to do is click onto it and then drag it onto the canvas and then release it. And then it's going to tell you what would you like to do, add it as a layer or replace. And then you'd simply hit replace. It's going to open up this page, and then you go ahead and click add, and it's now replaced our old image. So now if we were to bring the playhead a little bit back and hit play, this is what it now looks like. So we now replace the image, easy as that. So you'd go through all your different images, read what the text is saying, and then find something that's related to it and replace. Most times it does a good job. Like for example, for this first one, it's pretty good, it's fitting. This one is also fitting, so you won't have to replace all of them, just some of them. Now what we need to do is also add music. As you could see, it already has a sound because again, we did use a template. But if I did not like this sound, in order to add a new sound, what you'd need to do is bring your playhead to the beginning, and then you'd go go to this site over here where it says music, and then you would click music. And as you can see, there's over thousands of sounds you can choose from, and you can choose in regards to moods, you could choose in regards to genres, and you can even add in SFX sounds if you wanted to. So for example, if you wanted something in the relaxing scene, we'd go ahead and click onto where it says relaxing, and then you would click onto each of these sounds and hear what they sound like to see if it's something you want in your video. But when you found one that you like, in order to add it in, all you need to do is press the play button. And then if we scroll down, as you see, it's now been added in. So then you'd want to delete the one that it came with. And then in order to delete it, you'd simply right click onto it and click delete. And now you would have your new music that you added in. Now you don't want to keep the music at a high volume. You would always want to adjust it. And in order to adjust the volume, you'd want to click onto your music track, and then you'd go to where it says volume and fade. And then you'd want to bring it to something that is not too loud and overpowering. And then what you'd want to do is click onto a part of your video and then press play and just hear what it sounds like. Now once you have the clips together and your sound together, you need to add a voiceover. And in order to do this, you'd again want to come to the beginning of your video, and then as you can see, it says voiceover over here. You're going to click onto where it says voiceover, and then you're going to click automated text to speech. And then it's going to show you this little box with these three options below, where you can choose the type of voice you want, whether it's realistic or legacy. Then you could even select the different language you may want it in, as well as a different voice you would want. So hit play for all of these voices and see which one you prefer, and then just select it. And then in order to generate it, all you need to do is click generate voiceover. That took a second, but once you've done that, what you need to do is select this box at the bottom right here where it says add an automated voiceover for all scenes. That way you don't have to click and generate them individually. It's just going to generate them for your entire video. And once you've done that, what you need to do is click where it says add. And then once you've done that, if you take a look at the bottom, as you can see, it's generated all the voiceovers for us. So now this entire video is created and synced up together. And if it seems like a lot, you can always check out InVideo's YouTube channel, but this would be all you need in order to bulk create your videos. So now you need to export your video. And in order to do this, you're going to go to where it says export, and then be sure you have 1080p selected. And then you're going to go ahead and click where it says export. Once you click that, you're going to see this little box open on screen. InVideo is going to begin exporting your video for you. So all you have to do is wait for this to occur. And then once your video is done exporting, you'll be able to download it to your computer. In order to download it, all you need to do is locate the file in your projects, and it would have already taken you to this page. And all you need to do to actually download it once it's been exported is to come over to your project, and then you see these three icons here. You're gonna click the middle one which says download. And in order to actually export your videos, you need to have the paid plan. Using the free version of InVideo only allows you to actually create the videos, but you're not able to export them. So if we take a look at InVideo's pricing, it's about $30 per month for the business price, but you can get 25% off this subscription if you go ahead and use code MONS25. And I think it's worth it because of all the different features you get within one simple platform. But once you have this covered and you've created all your videos, all you need to do is download all 30 of your videos. Then you can go ahead and schedule them to be uploaded every single day of the month on your desired platform, whether that be Pinterest, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube Shorts. Take another hour and schedule them so that your content will be automatically uploaded and the monetizable traffic would be generated for you practically on autopilot. When it comes to social media, there are many different ways you can monetize your page, but I want to focus on the four most popular ways that you can do that I have done personally. And the first way to monetize your page is by doing affiliate marketing. This is where you recommend other people's products, services, softwares, ebooks, courses, anything using an affiliate link, which is your unique identifier. And then whenever the people that you recommend makes a purchase using your link, you would get paid a commission, which is a percentage of that sale. And affiliate commissions can range from as low as 2% to as high as even 100%. So affiliate marketing is always a great way to monetize because you don't have to create the product yourself. All you're doing is just writing off of somebody else's product and just sending traffic to that product and making money that way. The second way you can go about monetizing your page is by selling digital products. There are many different digital products that you can create, and that ranges from ebooks to courses to planners to digital files to printables, PDFs, anything that is not physical and can be sent to your audience digitally, you can create it and you can monetize it. And the best thing about digital products is that you have absolutely zero cost when it comes to having physical inventory. All you'll be investing into digital products is your time, and if you want to hire a designer or a freelancer to do it for you, then that's your decision. But if you take the project on yourself, whether it be creating an ebook, all you have invested in your time, and then when you get that audience, it's all 100% profit. The third item would be print on demand products, and that ranges from t-shirt, mugs, hoodies, stickers, pillowcases, anything that you could think of, you can probably find it on a print on demand website. And the one I love to use is Printify. Now print on demand products are physical products that you send to your customer, but you are also not spending any any money up front or even having physical inventory. How it works is that you create your design and then you upload that design to Printify onto the item you want to sell, whether that is a t-shirt. And then what happens is that when a customer actually purchases that t-shirt from you, and then Printify takes the money to create the products, package, ship it out to your customer, and then that leftover profit is yours. So you actually never need to physically see your items, physically have them, even purchase them. Now, if this sounds a little bit complicated, don't worry. I have many videos on my channel about this, so feel free to check them out. And the fourth and final way is sponsored posts or shoutouts. And this is where a company or a person would maybe send you a message, whether that be a DM, an email, a comment, and they would tell you that they are willing to pay you a price to maybe recommend their product on your social media or to give their page a shout out. Now, this happens more often than you think. And when it happens, be sure that you have your prices ready. So this is something you want to create beforehand. Now, note well that when you just start off with this, especially if your page is small, your prices will be lower. But remember, as your page grows, you can up your price. So yes, you may start off at $10 per shout out, but before you know it, you may be at $1,000 per shout out. Just keep in mind that sponsor posts and shout outs can be extremely lucrative as well. This is one of the best and easier ways to get started with making money online for beginners, and AI has made that process even easier. So go ahead and give it a try, or if you want to learn more ways you can make money online, then be sure to check out this other video on my channel.